Welcome everybody to the channel. I'm excited. I've been trying to do this for a couple months now about bringing content. I'm an amateur, so be patient with me. I'm still learning. Thank you, Jason, over at the 717 Project. Most of you probably found your way to my IG page through his channel. Thank you, Jason. I'm hoping I can just strive to bring some content as good as yours. I've already had some ups and downs this week, learning how to edit video. I've made some mistakes. If you like what you see, hit like, subscribe, give me some feedback. I definitely got a lot more I like to bring. This week I made a video of me installing speakers to replace the stocks. Little ups and downs, but that's okay. Let me know what you think. If you have any questions, I'll try to answer them. Let's roll some tape.
All right, here we go. Got my tools set up here. Here are the speakers, the JBL GX series 6.5, two ways. They come with brackets, foam, that stuff comes with the speakers, screws. Everything really comes with the speakers. You shouldn't really have to buy anything extra except for maybe wiring. we're going to have to drill pilot holes. There's already been a tap. 8 short, 8 long, and some clips. So we'll see what we can use here. I got to look at this, and then this goes to the speaker side. So as you can see right here, the holes line up perfectly with this grill. So should be able to find the right configuration to get these, this grill on here. I know it lines up with at least 2 of them. All right, looking at these, this is the outside. This is the flush part, goes against the door panel. This is the long slot. This is where you want to try to use to attach the spacer to the door panel. And then right here, there's little arrows inside right there. That's where you actually want to have the speaker screwed in to the actual spacer, so that uses it, so it fastens it. And then there's gaskets for the door and the speaker. For the, put a gasket there, put spacer on, and then you have gaskets to put in here to put it up against the spacer too. So the original way. The frame, the magnet frame and everything was banging up against the side and I wasn't getting 100% flush. So, gotta redo it. Again, be a little careful not to overdo it. You don't want to strip the head of the screw out. All right, there we go. That should be all good now. Take the speaker, JBL, on the bottom there, kind of line it up. Again, they have little arrows for there. There we go. And now I can get those actually lined up. It's flush. And then with these speakers, there's actually a deflector for the tweeters. This is straight up. You want the tweeters to kind of deflector to face towards the driver. So you're going to put them at a, like a 45 degree angle. If this is
all right, my
come to, we'll use these small screws, the short ones, to screw them into the speaker.
You got this bracket put on, lined up good. Drilled one pilot hole, went in, got another one, got it in. Once it was set, then I did the last two. Clipped off the original clip. We had real thin wire, real thin gauge. All I got is regular good speaker wire. Ended up up soldering. Got a nice firm connection there. I kind of want to stop. There we go. Remember, tweeter, 45 degree angle towards the... I'm gonna turn it on again, see how it sounds. Now this one, you gotta be careful, the tweeter. So the tweeter's all parallel. So there's a little tiny clip. You pinch it right on the top, right there, pinch it down and pull. There's the tweeter, so if you're gonna redo the tweeters, that's where it goes. Oh, another thing. So like this tab right here, this green one that's stuck in there, you wanna go out and you wanna pull that out, and you want to put it back in here because it will not go on 100% if you leave that there, and then when you go back and try to pop all of them back on, that one is not going to necessarily catch on the inside. So I didn't show you on the front, but that's what you need to do every time you pull a panel off. Do that. The two screws that are holding on this bracket, this one and this one, the heads went right through the ridge, and so it popped off. So I'm gonna have to get another screw with a bigger head. I think I have some self-tapping screws too. And put that right there, and put one right there, and get that back in, and then I can get the speaker back on. Because what happens, I did that, and then all of a sudden, pulled the speaker. When I tightened the speaker out, it pulled the bracket off. So one thing I have a lot of around here is some extra screws. Look, I got some bigger, thicker head. Gonna go in there, put those down. Hopefully that head will catch on in that right there, and then get it in far enough to where I can push it through, and got to get it flush. That's what I'm concerned about.
Full disclosure, I don't have any more video of finishing the install. I accidentally deleted when I was doing my first edit, so I'm now re-recording. So once I got the speaker mounted, using the bigger head screws to put the bracket back on and making sure those screws are flush so the speaker fits flush on the bracket. So tip number one, when aligning the bracket to the door panel, I found that the best fitment is if you put the speaker holes at the one of them at the 12 o'clock position at the top. So the speaker mounts to where it gets best clearance behind and stays flush. Tip number two, I would buy a second set or pair of mounting brackets. These brackets, once you screw in, screw out, screw in, they get brittle and they break. So having just an extra pair lying around is just a good idea. Tip number three, referencing the guide that I got, crutchfield.com. I go there to use them as a reference to find products, to find part numbers, They also have wiring harnesses and those mounting brackets, so you can find part numbers for the brands that they use. They also have installation guides. Now, when you buy a product from them, the installation guides come for free, but you can buy those installation guides separate and they send them to you on a PDF. Definitely recommend that. And since I lost the video of the speakers after I got them installed, I'm gonna go ahead and record some new video and see how they sound now. Guys, what'd you think? I definitely want to bring some more content. That roof right there, I think it needs to be wrapped in glossy black. Let me know what you think about that. I definitely got some more stuff. I do have a subwoofer from an old car that I like to get put in. Again, I want to say thank you to Jason at the 717 Project. Thank you for everybody come checking out my channel. Thank you for being patient with me while I work through this being a rookie. Once I figure all this out, I definitely want to step up my game. Let me know what project you might like to see next. Maybe I can get that done in the next video. I'm out.